Hi guys, my name is Harry, and I studied biochemistry at Oxford University in class of 2010, and I'm here to share with all Oxford biochemistry applicants what kind of interview questions you can expect in December. Alright, so I prepared what I thought was the most difficult question at my interview, which was, given that the selectivity filter is lined with carbonyl oxygens, how might a potassium ion channel allow potassium ion through, but not sodium ion? So, to help you guys picture the question, I drew out this diagram where carbonyl oxygens are pointing towards the incoming potassium ion, and the filter width is just wide enough to fit in one potassium ion. So, the real question is, why can't sodium ions, which have the same effective nuclear charge of 1+, pass through the ion channel when it's actually smaller? Interviewers wouldn't expect you to know the whole answer, but we can start by stating the obvious, that there exists electrostatic attraction between positively charged potassium ions and negatively charged carbonyl oxygens, and that potassium ions are smaller than sodium ions. We need to catch up the point that when a potassium ion enters the channel, it's losing its hydrogen shell for new interaction with carbonyl oxygens, and that this new interaction, the energy gain from this new interaction, is large enough to compensate the loss of hydration. Now the answer. Because a sodium ion is smaller than a potassium ion, its reduced proximity to carbonyl oxygens means that the resulting electrostatic interaction is weaker than the potassium ions and insufficient to compensate sodium ions' loss of hydration. Quite interesting, right? So there we go, our answer to the ion channel question. We hope that you enjoyed our intellectually stimulating what to expect in Oxbridge interviews video. Would like to encourage you to get in touch with us for more information to learn more about Oxford biochemistry interviews.